Doc Rivers, this Milwaukee Bucks team is a complete catastrophe. Why is Doc Rivers employed? That's a societal problem. Jay Crowder's not going to be able to guard the ball here. Not going to be able to guard the ball. So Malik Beasley's got to step up and take the ball, and Jay Crowder's just got to move over to Emmanuel Quigley. You're late getting back. Happens all the time. No one communicates. Both take the ball. Guess what happens? This is such a stupid mistake. How are these happening in April? Guard the ball if you're Damian Lillard. When the screen happens, you'll guard it when it happens. You lean towards the screen before Kelly Olynyk even thinks. He's not even trying to set a screen. And you're leaning towards it. And toasted. The NBA has a real problem on its hands. It has a real coaching problem. Doc Rivers is just one of the many. This is not defense. This product is crap. I could be coming off this screen and be left open and hit a three. Get up and hedge! Move Emmanuel Quigley to the sidelines. There's no place for Olynyk to roll to or pop to. Look at this. This could be me. This could be you. This could be someone out handing out cotton candy. It's just come off screen, be wide open. That's illegal. That's criminal. This is Doc Rivers being miserable. Ball gets thrown to the top of the key. AJ Green should be immediately rotating to the top of the key, seeing both ball and man. That's how we guard away from the ball. You got your back to the ball. There's absolutely no reason to be switching this down screen. Danilo Gallinari can easily just chase over the top, and AJ Green stays connected to his man. But you're switching. Fine. So AJ Green better immediately get underneath on the switch. Immediately underneath on the switch. Nowhere close. Now Middleton's got to help, and RJ Barrett's left open for three. Doc Rivers! The Bucks actually decide that giving up wide open threes is not a great idea. So they hedge here. Everything's fine. Damian Lillard gets in backside help. Malik Beasley, just guard the ball at the top of the key. What is Malik Beasley doing here? Like, what? You just left your feet to get a deflection on a pass that isn't happening. And it... blown by! Bucks are back in drop coverage. Malik Beasley here. You're in backside help. So I want to tag. I want to jam Kelly Olynyk as he comes through on this roll right here. Right? And then I'm right back out to Gary Trent. So first of all, you don't jam Kelly Olynyk. You don't do anything. But okay, fine. Now we got to get back out. Like, we're not in backside help anymore. We're back out. Back out. Like, Malik Beasley staring at the ball and not recovering back out. So he's beat. By the way, Kelly Olynyk sets a screen. Could Brook Lopez please be up ready to switch? No. Everything no. This is coaching. This is a complete disaster. Doc Rivers being in the NBA is a problem for everyone in the world. Malik Beasley, you go under this fake handoff right here and meet Quigley on the other side. You're going over the handoff right here. So now when Emmanuel Quigley sets a down screen that you're apparently supposed to switch, you're nowhere. What is Damian Lillard doing? The Bucks are a complete circus. Damian, just stay with Gary Trent. There's no screen happening. Why is Damian Lillard not lifting with Gary Trent? And why is he calling out for a switch? He's not being screened. It's Jay Crowder who's being screened. It's the end of the half. The shot goes up. Gang rebounding means everybody boxes out and there's no chance for Toronto to get an offensive rebound at the end of the half. This would be the opposite of that. Jay Crowder is the only person boxing out here. Nobody in the paint decides to box out. Bucket at the end of the half. This is a crime. This is illegal. This is the NBA. People pay money to watch this. This does not need to be Emmanuel Quigley. This can be someone from the stands, a homeless person. Could you get up and hedge? There's no place for Kelly Olynyk to roll to or pop to. Look at the Bucks pick and roll defense. It's to have Emmanuel Quigley come off screen after screen and just be wide open. It's embarrassing. Want to help on the ball? You can't backpedal. Chris Middleton, first of all, should be up stopping the ball. AJ Green should be up and help. Okay? We're up stopping the ball. We're up and help so we can help and recover. When everybody backpedals, now we got to backpedal to the paint. And nobody's getting out to Gary Trent now. But how do you even explain this? What is Damian Lillard doing defensively here? You're guarding Gary Trent. Why do you ignore Gary Trent to go into the paint? To do what? What are you accomplishing here? The Bucks are an absolute circus. There are pickup basketball games with more attention to detail and better coaching. First of all, could Andre Jackson not gamble at a pass that doesn't even get made? How about Bobby Portis? Why are you not up guarding Gary Trent Jr.? So Andre Jackson's gambling. Bobby Portis is, I don't know what he's doing, and he's not ready to guard now for some reason. Look at this. Not even close. Rip and go drive. Because you were in the paint. Doing what? Damian Lillard again. How do you describe this? Obviously the help is coming from Bobby Portis at the top of the key. So stay home on Grady Dick. How do you describe... What do the Bucks do in film? What do they do in practice? Bobby Portis isn't help here. Why is Damian Lillard underneath the rim? What are you doing? It's just undisciplined. It's poorly coached. This team's a complete mess. There's no coaching. Doc Rivers should not be allowed to coach basketball at the youth level, middle school, high school. Bobby Portis, can you just guard Jalen McDaniels? Why do you have to make this asinine gamble? Just, this is the most ridiculous clip of them all. There should be nobody at a Bucks game watching a Bucks game as long as Doc Rivers is allowed to destroy this franchise. And Dave Yeager, another moron, completely incompetent. This is disgusting. Chris Middleton's guarding on the wing. Bobby Portis is guarding at the top of the key. You cannot, in the middle of the play, just switch assignments out of the blue. Look at this. What is happening here? This is, again, this is, you can't eat, like, this has to be a movie. This has to be a comedy. Doc, this is, Andre Jackson Jr. is guarding Emmanuel Quigley here. Okay, Bobby Portis, you are not a part of this in any way, shape, or form. Could you stay with Gary Trent? Where's Bobby Portis going? Why are three Bucks players guarding Emmanuel Quigley? How do you describe this? How is Doc Rivers in the league? Well, the Bucks actually hedge here. First of all, Bobby Portis should be all the way up. You got to cut that dribble. Emmanuel Quigley should be pushed to the sidelines. You're not even close to hedging high enough. By the way, AJ Green, you should be in backside help. The pass to Kelly Olynyk cannot get made. So Bobby Portis isn't hedging high enough. AJ Green gets in backside help late. So now Bobby Portis on the recovery. Clearly you're going to have to take RJ Barrett and you bump Pat Connaughton to the corner. You work on this stuff. This is why you have film and practice. Where's Bobby Portis going? Where are you going right now? What? This is unbelievable. This is the two-point game. The Raptors are in the bonus. Andre Jackson Jr., coaching, get underneath the screener on the switch. Underneath every time. You switch over the top, and then because you're late to switch, you yank Kelly Olynyk down, and that's a two-shot foul. Oh, and then mix in a stupid technical foul there on Bobby Portis, and this game's over.